discussion with the three political group leaders, it has been agreed that the following members will address council in relation to this matter. I'm going to read their names out and then I'll come back to the first. Okay, can I first of all have clarification on the Liberal Democrat spokesperson? Who's the person who's going to speak on this matter? Is it the deputy group leader for the Liberal Democrat group, Councillor Dave Mitchell?
Thank you, Madam Mayor. We discussed the matter and we felt our member with most experience on children's services currently is most appropriate. So Councillor Brookhouse will be our second speaker.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Councillor Plum. If she serves her ward as diligently and as carefully as a certain previous councillor would, the people of Portland and Nocturne will be forever in her debt. Madam Mayor, we now turn to the request for the debate tonight. The Conservative Group has requested this item in view of the events of the last few days and in the last 24 hours and the utterly reprehensible crimes that have been revealed that have been going on under the watchful eye of this Council for several years. Madam Mayor, this is an opportunity for all 66 of us who we have been told time and time again, particularly since the Ofsted report, that we are each corporate parents of the children in our care. It is now an opportunity for the Leader of the Council to tell us what has been going on and more specifically what went wrong. For 9 months since Ofsted, since their damning report, we have been told that things are getting better, that those with the responsibility for the department, both elected and employed, have everything in hand. For 9 months, Madam Mayor, members of all four political parties have been expressing their concerns, either in private or, in the case of the Conservative Group, Liberal Democrats and Greens, in public. For 9 months or longer, many of us have received harrowing and at times distressing calls from families who know only too well how this department has failed and is failing them. Madam Mayor, only today I received a call from a West Kirby resident, completely at the end of her tether, completely frustrated, who has tried multiple people within this council to take their concerns to. The only advice I could offer was to go back to her ward councillor. Tonight, Madam Mayor, I would hope the leader of the council could explain why the cabinet member, who is absent tonight, but who 9 months ago he said was the right person to lead his department, is no longer in post. It is not enough, Madam Mayor, for the two most senior people in the department to, as I quote Councillor Jeff Green, be thrown under the bus. The buck did not stop with Councillor Smith and the departing director. Both reported directly to him and to his chief executive in this council. Madam Mayor, like parents and carers across Wirral, the Conservative Group on this council has no faith whatsoever that the lessons have been learned or that this department is being well led. It is now time, Madam Mayor, for the running of this service and the lives entrusted to it. Young lives from often chaotic families, abused and neglected young people, to be given the very best protection that is available. It is clear, Madam Mayor, that Wirral Council is not, in the present circumstances, up to this task. Madam Mayor, it is our view that such is the chaos in this department that expecting this problem to be managed in-house is no longer feasible. Nor is it acceptable to expect unelected individuals to manage the department under the guise of an improvement board that meets in secret. Extra support and guidance to this council is required. Not one person on this council can hold the improvement board to account in public. That is not good enough. For that reason, Madam Mayor, the Conservative Group will be asking for government intervention, as we've seen in other failing authorities with similar cases, as we've seen in the Liverpool Echo and other media over the last 48 hours. Madam Mayor, whether this happens or not, the Conservative Group will not sit quietly while those in authority, such as Councillor Davis, utter platitudes and wring their hands. We will hold this administration to account before, during and after the serious case review and at every opportunity from now on. Madam Mayor,
consistent effective leadership when various people came and went. Those are the difficulties, and I have spent some time, if you don't convince the recruitment board, you'll find often question things about recruitment and training and whether things have been followed through. I will play a full part in the bodies that the leader has set up, but of course, experienced teachers need always to ask behind what we're being told and to press for information. I know that the recent Ofsted report letter will come out after PERDA, and I ask members to look at that thoroughly. I also ask them to look at the minutes of the improvement board and to ask about progress, because unless we keep pressure up, progress may not be sustained. So, Madam Mayor, thank you for your courtesy. Before I close, welcome Councillor Wood to the council, because we're all here for public service. We're here to protect the vulnerable and children, and I'm determined that that will take place and the questioning will be thorough.
Thank you, Councillor
Chris. Councillor Ray. Thank you, Madam Mayor. Madam Mayor, I too would want to put on allowing vulnerable young people
instead of doing all that, we should actually be concentrating on the real job, the job in hand. Recently, the one of the children's trust and finish groups discussed the need to sit down with a representative group of social workers to understand what is actually happening and what's going on within the department. And he couldn't help but welcome that. But one of the driving forces behind it was clearly that actually there does appear to be a lack and a loss of trust in what we're being told. And we're not being told. I mean, I've been on this council now for quite a few years, and always from the beginning we thought about transparency and openness, but actually, even today, we seem to be miles away from it. And as Councillor Rennie has just said, how many more times will the leader of the council have to stand up and say, lessons must be learned? Too many times, we do fail to take the initiative. So come on, let's stop these grand gestures. Yes, ineffective reorganisations. And let's start doing what the residents of Wirral expect. Thank you, Madam Mayor.
Also clear that our services are very different today. A huge officers have been trained, every school has had training, every nurse, every professional with a responsibility to ensure child safety has been trained to spot the dangers that take action. We are incredibly sorry for the pain that these girls have suffered. We can also do much more to make sure that every public agency learns from the experience. What I can say is I ask all of you to have for your support. I will do everything I possibly can to lead a cross-party approach to this and make sure that as far as possible this never, ever, ever happens to another child on the world. Thank you.
Terms of this service. We have new political leadership in Burnley. I'm confident that Burnley will bring that fresh approach to this area. We'll have new officer leadership from now on. I just would ask members to just acknowledge really, and I understand that everybody's not, you know, had been privy to the discussions in the group and board, but a number of improvements have been made. We have moved forward since the Ofsted report has been published. And don't just take my word for it, Maggie Atkinson, former Children's Commissioner for England, please listen to the interview. But she does say, and I'll quote her again, if you go into these services again today, you will find that they are very different. Lessons have already been learned. Not my words, the words of Dr. Maggie Atkinson, the Chair of the Safeguarding Board, former Children's Commissioner for England. So there is, I think, independent assurance that we are moving forward. Councillor Lewis talks about government intervention. I, for one, do not believe that the answer to all of our problems is for government commissioners to move in. I think local elected members and the Office of Conservers are much better than a Mandarin or any of those outside person. But having said that, I just want to assure Councillor Lewis, I don't know if you noticed, we've already got the government involved in our children's services. So we have, so I don't know if you know this, but we have Tony Crane, a DfE appointed by the Secretary of State advisor, who is working with our children's services, who sits on the improvement board, who is working very closely with all our senior officers. So the government is there. They have a senior civil servant from the DfE who I met last week. So to say that, you know, we've got the government involved, but it's part of the improvement board. And my sort of final point, really, Madam Mayor, is just a plea again to members. This issue is too important to be used as a political stick to beat anybody with. It really is. And this is not me trying to duck responsibility. I do believe that the way forward is through a